Hey, welcome back to Coding at Home. Today we are gonna play a solitaire, which means that we have only one team, only one robot, and we can even play alone. But today I'm with Anna, and I will let Anna play the solitaire. The solitaire is called the snake because the robot will behave as a snake. And the goal of the game, the goal of the solitaire, is to make the robot visit as many squares as possible without biting his tail. So this means that when the robot moves, it will leave traces behind him, and it cannot move into the boxes that were already visited, because this represents kind of a tail that cannot be beaten. Okay, so I called it a solitaire because there is some randomness that is provided as usual by the shuffled deck of Cody Robbie cards. So this means that in order to decide how to move the robot, Anna can just take a decision that is based on the cards that she will have in hands. And at every turn, she will take from the deck only three cards. And the three cards that she has in hand, in this case, are the same. So this means that she has no choice, because at every turn she can just play one of the three cards. If the three cards are the same, this means that she can only tell her robot to move forward. So, just as an example, in this case, the robot will move there, and Anna, please, could you add the trace?
Yes.
Okay. So, this is a way of marking the fact that the C1 square has already been visited and cannot be visited again. Okay, then we take another card from the deck, like this one, and right now there is some degree of freedom. And for instance, Anna, just as an example, make your move. Okay, if you decide to go right, okay, this is to turn right, sorry, this is the effect. You take another card and you can again decide how to move, and so on. Okay, but now we restart from scratch and from a corner, which is a more typical way of more typical starting point for this game. And you can shuffle the deck. Great. And put it on the table and take, okay, I take cards and you and you move. Okay. So one, two, three. Those are very good cards because they are all different, and so you have all the possible choices, because those are all the cards in our instruction set, actually.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, please remember the cards that we had in hand at the first turn, in case something goes wrong. Because I have something to tell you, just in case. Okay. Okay, notice that our goal is to make the robot visit as many squares as possible before getting stuck, because at some point the robot risks to get stuck just because it cannot move in any already visited square. And the maximum number of squares that you can visit is how many?
24.
24, because the 25th is the one that you started from. Okay. So this means that the true goal is to move on all the possible squares, but it's not necessarily feasible with the cards that you will have in chance. Okay. Okay. This is probably a good move because it is not just a matter of randomness, because at some point you can even take a decision which makes it impossible to find the path that goes over all the squares without going twice on any square, okay? And probably moving at this point to the middle of the checkered board would have ended in this kind of situation. Okay. Okay, it makes sense, but you are wasting a lot of turning cards.
I know.
Which is quite rare. Okay. Good. No choice. Yeah, you could have, yes, okay. Just to explain something more, if Anna decided to play this card, then she would have ended facing the border of the checkered board, which is feasible at this point, but having in hand just to move forward cards. Meaning that if the next card was a move forward again, then the robot was stuck and she ended up losing the game. Okay, so this is the situation, and we go ahead. Not that bad. Quite lucky. This is a useful one.
Yes.
Wow. Okay. Okay. Played the same. Okay. okay, makes sense. You can even go that way.
Yeah.
It's a little bit risky.
I can try.
Okay. Okay. So it's still feasible because there is a path, but it depends on the cards that Anna will draw from the deck, or I will draw for her from the deck. Okay. Okay, critical point.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now this is the only card that she can play. This is the stucky situation that means that actually the performance in this match is represented by the number of squares that you were able to visit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, and 20. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I could have counted the remaining ones. So 20. This means that this could even be played as a competitive game because now I could try to make a better performance. And in case I manage not necessarily to solve the solitaire, but at least to visit more than 20 squares, then I will win against Anna. Okay? But before saying you goodbye, I'd like to show you how to play without a deck of cards. And to this purpose, you can download from the web this sheet of paper with many very small cards. You can find it in color in on the web, but I decided to print it out in grayscale just because it's much more common to have a black and white printer at home. And in this case, you can just color the arrow according to our color scheme. So move forward is green, turn left is yellow, and turn right is red. And those are 40 cards, exactly as in our deck that contains 40 cards, 24 green cards, 8 yellow cards, and 8 red cards. Okay, let me show you how to use it for instead of a deck. Since we had to draw 3 cards from the deck, starting from this point, so the upper left, I can take these first 3 cards, which are green, yellow, green. And starting from instance from here, so that I show you also, let me take it as a starting point, C3, to show you that changing the starting position changes the game a lot, because the path is completely different, the path that will bring the robot visiting all the possible squares. So right now, Anna has to choose among these 3 cards.
Move forward.
Okay, please. Okay, move forward means that this has been played. Okay, could you please, get it here, a marker, because it makes it much more visible. Okay, so those are the 3 cards that we drew from the deck, and this is the one that we played. Now I take another one, and those are the 3 that you have in hands.
Okay.
Okay, move forward. So this is the one that she has played, and this is the new one. So right now you have this, this, and this.
Turn left.
Okay. And now you have these 3.
Forward.
Okay, and now you have these 3, red, green, green. You see, so this is a way of using this instead of a deck of cards. But there is something different, because in this case you can foresee what is gonna happen. So you can implement a strategy. And this is not a random game anymore. You can play it as you didn't know in advance the cards in the deck, the order of the cards in the deck. But instead of just playing it as if you were using a deck, you can try to figure out which strategy to apply, starting from this position and knowing the order in which the cards will be drawn. Okay? And this is very, very difficult, actually, to conceive a strategy taking everything into account. And I'd like also to tell you that in case you decided to use this sheet of paper, you can use it more than once, because if you decided to start from here rather than from here, then the game will be completely different. Then you can decide to start from here, to start from here. So you can change the starting point and use the entire deck so that at the end you restart from here. So you can change the starting point and you have 40 different starting points here, and you can change the starting point of the robot and you have 25 times 4, more or less, because in the borders you cannot, actually you could even start from here, is not the best starting position, but you could. So you have 100 starting points here and 40 starting points here. So let's imagine how many different games you can play. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.